Good morning class. Our today's topic is seronegative spondyloarthropathies. It is a group of inflammatory disorders which include a synovial inflammation or the synovium sheath inflammation of the synovial joints. In this presentation, we will discuss about the definition, etiopathogenesis, pathology, clinical features, investigation, differential diagnosis, and the treatment. So what is spondyloarthropathies? It is a group of inflammatory arthropathies affecting the synovium and the enthesis, leading to the spinal and the oligoarticular peripheral arthritis in genetically predisposing individual with HLA-B27. It includes the following, that is your AS, JAS, psoriatic arthritis, reactive arthritis, and the arthropathy with IBD or also known as enteropathic arthritis. AS means ankylosing spondylitis, JAS means juvenile ankylosing spondylitis, and the psoriatic arthritis, reactive, and the arthropathy. Strong association with the above condition with the mucosal ulceration. If you have present a patient come with the mucosal ulceration and the inflammatory ocular diseases are there, and the negative rheumatic factor and the positive HLA-B27 is there and the positive family history. So these are the strong association with the inflammatory arthropathy. What are the pathology? First, involvement of the SI joint followed by the lumbar spine and upwards. Pain subside once bony ankylosing occurs at the end result of the pathological process, leaving behind a permanently stiff spine for rest of the life. It is also known as burnt out disease. What are the pathological sequence? First, your synovitis. Synovitis means inflammation of the synovial sheath. Synovial sheath that covers your synovial joint. Then after the synovial inflammation, there is a cartilage destruction. After synovial inflammation, there is a destruction of the cartilage. Then after bony erosion, your bone will be eroded. Then it results into the fibrosis of the joint. Then the fibrosis ankylosis. Fibrous ankylosis means the fusion of the joint, and there is a bony ankylosis. After the fibrous ankylosis, there is a bone will become stiff or ankylosed. Ankylosed means fused. Age less than 40 to 45 years, and the gender predisposition, that is predominantly male affected more, and the presentation progressive inflammatory lower back pain of more than 3 month duration associated with early morning stiffness which get relieved typically with the exercise or the activity. Articular manifestations are what are the joints include, that is your axial skeleton, anterior central joint, and the proximal joints. Axial means your spine or the vertebral, that is SI joint first include because it's a large joint, and the intervertebral joints and the fascia joints and the costovertebral joints where your ribs are attached, that is your thoracic spine, and the anterior central joint, that is anterior joints means sternoclavicular, that manubriosternal, and the pubic symphysis of the pubis. And the large proximal joint, that is your hip, knee, and the shoulder. Progressive low back pain can occur. Back stiffness onset, that is gradual onset. Nature of pain, initially dull, aching, unilateral, intermittent, but later on bilateral, and the constant pain will be there. Acute referred pain, sciatic nerve compression. If your sciatic nerve is compressed, then your patient can complain of the radiating pain. Then progressive limitation of the spinal movement, enthesis of the spinous process, iliac crest, greater trochanter, ischial tuberosities. These are the symptoms of the SI joint. Other spinal features are thoracic region. There is a reduced chest expansion because of the fusion and the inflammation. patient feel pain, that's why patient is not able to breathe properly, or there is a lack of chest expansion, reduce vital capacity, patient dependent on the diaphragm for the respiration, chest pain due to enthesopathy or the costovertebral joint, costo-external joint or the manubrio-sternal joint. Cervical region, that is your neck pain. Secondary, poking chain. Poking chain means forward head posture or subluxation is there. Hip joint, progressive flexion deformity, stiffness, and the later on bony ankylosing of the joint. Knee, intermittent pain and the joint effusion episodes. Ankle foot enthesopathy of the calcaneum. So there is a calcaneal spur also occur, or the it causes the T heel pain, or the your tendo Achilles. Where is your heel pain? At the tendo Achilles joint or the insertion. Then some extra articular feature. Extra articular means other than the joints. The feature other than the joint, that is your vision, central nervous system, cardiovascular system, pulmonary, GIT, renal and the skin. Vision, acute uveitis, iritis, or in the 20-30% people, cases without any correlation with the disease process, recurrent episodes can result into the depigmentation or the scarring. Serious, spontaneous, subluxation, fractures with a trivial trauma, cord compression, and the cardiovascular system, there is a ascending aortis, aortic incompetence, and the conduction defects, cardiomegaly, cardiomyopathy, and the pericardial effusions are there. In the pulmonary system, there is an upper lobe fibrosis of the lung, and the GIT, there is the colitis and IBD, and the renal neuropathy and the renal impairments are there. In the skin, there is a associated psoriasis and generalized osteoporosis. These are the extra articular features in the ankylosing spondylitis. What are the physical findings? Physical findings are the posture is the forward stoop posture, or the straightened of the lumbar spine, or your obliterated lumbar lordosis, your lumbar lordosis becomes straight or obliterated. Diffuse kyphosis of the thoracic spine, that is your round back. Lower cervical spine flexion with the upper cervical spine hyperextension, that is your poking chain or the forward bend, forward head posture. And hip knee flexion is there because of the fusion, and the progressive flexed posture becomes a problem when it forward vision is restricted to only few steps ahead, because your head is not moving, you are not able to see behind or sideways, your head becomes like this. So that is your forward head posture. Gait, stiff robotic gait, patient is walk like a stiff robot. So in this picture you can see the forward head posture, your knees flexed, hip is flexed, and your shoulder is extended, elbows are flexed, and the patient is become stiff, or the there is forward. In the lateral view you can see the forward head posture or the poking chin posture, your back is round, your lordosis is obliterate. Here you can see the shoulder position and the hip is flexed. Here you can see the hip is flexed, knee is flexed, then patient is walking in the robotic gait. So SI joint compression, what are the tests we can do for the ankylosing spondylitis? SI joint compression test, which will be positive, Jensen test positive, pump handle positive, Patrick Fabers positive, SLR, you can do SLR for the neuropathies, and you can check the lumbar spine stiffness. What you can do the Schubert's test, thoracic spine, you can do check by the chest expansion test. For the cervical spine, you can do the Pleach test, tape measurement, finger to tip and the flow distance, spinal goniometry measurement, and spine dialogometer. So these are the some tests or the special tests you can do, or you can assess the patient of the ankylosing spondylitis. What are the investigation we are going to do? That is HLA-B27, that is positive, and the radiological changes. Radiological changes mean your X-ray changes. In X-ray, we can go for the pelvis, lumbar spine, and the peripheral large joint. And AP view of the pelvis, AP view means anteroposterior, anterior to posterior view, oblique view from the side, and the lateral view of the lumbar spine. So what are the clinical or the X-ray findings we can observe in the X-ray? That is haziness of the SI joint, irregular subchondral erosion, sclerosis of the articular surface, bony ankylosis, the fusion of bone, and the calcification of attachments of the muscle, tendon, ligaments, and the particularly sacroiliac, sacrotuberous ligament around the pelvis. So first is the X-ray of spine, inflammation of the superficial fibers of annulus fibrosus at the sites of the attachment to the corner of the vertebral body and result into the reactive bone sclerosis, that is your shiny corners. So your vertebra represent a shiny corners, subsequent bone ridge option leading to the squaring of vertebra. So there is a squaring of vertebra is also there, that is a loss of normal anterior concavity of the vertebral body. And the third one is your facetal fusion, your facet joint will be fused, and the ligamentous ossification is also there, that is ligament are there, that is ALL, anterior longitudinal ligament, and the posterior longitudinal ligament. In the long standing or the severe cases, what will be happen, there is a ossification of the superior layer of the annulus fibrosis leads to the bridging of the osteophytes, that is your also known as syndesmophytes, giving to rise to the characteristic bamboo spine appearance of the vertebral column. Osteoporosis, particularly body of the lumbar spine and the femoral neck. So here you can see these are the X-ray of the spine. You can see the shiny corners, here the lightening, you can see the sclerosis and the fusion of spine, you can observe in this X-ray. In this X-ray, you can see the squaring of vertebra. There is a loss of anterior concavity. Okay. Normally, our vertebra shows the anterior concavity. But in this X-ray, you can see there is a squaring from edge. From anteriorly, there is a squarish shape of the vertebra. So there is a calcification. You can see the anterior and the posterior, there is a calcified of the longitudinal ligaments, there is a calcification of the fusion, there is a calcium deposit in the longitudinal ligaments. So bamboo spine or the syndesmophytes, here you can see it looks like a bamboo. Okay, bamboo looks like this. There is a knot or this syndesmophytes. This is a knot, this is there is a knot, there is a knot. So it looks like a bamboo.